Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I am going to explain you bus contention and bus arbitration technique. My dear students, there are three interesting techniques which is there based on bus contention and bus arbitration. First is daisy chain, second is polling, and third is independent request. My dear students, I have seen this topic is frequently coming in university examination as well as in competitive examination. So as if you are preparing for competitive examination, definitely there will be one question based on this video. I'll be explaining you each and every parameters regarding bus contention and bus arbitration. Let us try to understand first what is the meaning of bus contention. See, when you are there with network, at that time, in network, there are multiple systems. You can say multiple computers are there, or you can say multiple nodes are there. So those multiple systems wants to access system bus. The reason is that network is connected with system bus. So which system will be accessing system bus, that has to be decided based on some techniques. That is referred as bus contention. For example, in your network, there are 10 computers. Let us say out of those 10 computers, computer number 4 wants to access system bus. Then there are techniques by which we can give bus grant to computer number 4. How that will be done with respect to three different techniques? Let us try to understand all those things step by step. So first of all, I'll be explaining you first technique, that is daisy chain method. So if you observe the basic diagram of daisy chain method, in which this is bus arbiter controller. Now bus arbiter controller is having three different types of signals. You see, one is bus grant, second is bus request, and third is bus busy. See, this bus busy line that will be active as if any system is using system bus. For example, as if system N is using system bus right now, then this system N will be making this line active. Means bus arbiter controller will be having idea about out of all the systems, at least one system is using system bus right now. Now, I want to explain you a case in which how daisy chain method is granting system bus to any system, right? So let us say no system is using system bus right now. What it means? Bus busy line that will be inactive. During that period, let us say system 2 is asking for bus grant. So system 2 that will be sending signal of bus request over this black color line, right? If you observe over here, bus request line that is common for all the systems. In daisy chain method, bus request line that is only one for all the system. So single wire is there for bus request line, right? System 2 is asking for bus request. Here, my dear students, bus arbiter does not have idea about which system is asking for bus request. Remember this. The reason is there is only one line. So from one line, we cannot have idea about which system is asking for bus request. But bus arbiter controller will be having idea about, okay, somebody is asking for bus request, right? So what bus arbiter controller will do in daisy chain? Bus arbiter controller that will send bus grant via this first line that will go to system 1. Right now system 1 is not interested about bus. So system 1 will forward that to system 2. Right now system 2 is interested about that bus request, right? So system 2 will take control of system and it will make that bus busy line active over here. As if system 2 is not interested, then it will carry forward it to next system. So here, my dear students, in sequence, bus grant is being forwarded. So obviously, highest priority that will be there with which system? First system. Then second system will be having second highest priority. Third will be having third highest priority. That is how things will be there. Here, there are a few disadvantages that you should know. Like as if any system fails over here, then after that system, whatever systems are there, those systems cannot have access of system bus, right? For example, right now, if I say system 2 is getting failed, so after system 2, no system can have bus grant. Why? The reason is system 2 cannot forward that bus grant signal to next system, right? So if any system fails over here, then next system cannot access system bus. That is the disadvantage. Second disadvantage is what? Here, my dear students, even though system 1 is not interested, first priority will be given to system 1, right? The reason is bus grant that will be first given to system 1. If system 1 is not interested, then it will be given to system 2. So here, even though priority is not there with system 1, first it will be given to system 1, right? It is like Rahul Gandhi is given to priority as Congress president, even though he is not eligible or not, right? So same thing is happening over here. Let us try to understand now second method, that is polling method. So in polling method, my dear students, what is happening, you see? Bus busy line, that is common for all the system. What is the meaning of bus busy line? If any system is accessing system bus, then it will make that line active. Means bus arbiter controller will be having idea about out of all the system, it is possible that any one system is using system bus arbiter. Right. Consider no system is using system bus. So this bus busy line, that will be inactive. Now here, if you observe bus request line, that is common for all. By black color, I have shown over here. That explains you bus request line, that is common for all the system in polling method. But if you observe bus grant line, so that is there based on address, right? It is not single line. If you observe with daisy chain method, bus grant line was one only, right? And that was forwarded from one computer to other computer. But with polling method, if you observe here, bus grant address will be there, right? And now how system bus access will be granted to any system, let us try to understand that. So here, my dear students, for example, bus busy line is inactive, means no system is using system bus. In that situation, let us say system 2 is asking for bus control. So via this black color line, it will be sending bus request to bus arbiter controller. Now as bus request is coming over here, what will happen with bus arbiter controller? Now bus arbiter controller will be having idea about somebody is asking for system bus. Still, there is only one line. So bus arbiter controller will not be having idea about which system is asking for bus control. But bus arbiter controller will be having idea about somebody is asking for bus control. So now in polling method, what will happen? There will be well-defined priorities. And based on priorities, in sequence, polling will be done. Polling means here on bus grant address, first priority will be given to one system. Then next priority will be given to second system. That is how in sequence address will be translated over here. For example, let us say highest priority is there with system 4. So first address, that will be regarding system 4 over here, even though system 4 is not interested. After that, second priority will be polled over here, right? After that, third priority will be polled over here. Let us say here we are having fifth priority, that is there with system 2. So fifth priority, that will be coming as address over here, and system 2 that will got to know like, okay, now my address is being granted by bus arbiter controller, so I should take over the control of system bus, right? That is how in polling, one by one address will be polled by bus arbiter controller, and then at last system will take control of system bus, right? So in polling, one by one address will be polled over here based on priority, and based on priority system will take bus access, right? Now last method, that is quite interesting, you see. In independent request method, what is happening, you see? Bus grant line and bus request line, that is individually provided to all the system. So in independent request method, my dear students, you will be observing bus arbiter controller will be having idea about which system is asking for bus request. Like if you observe previously, we have been having common bus request line, right? But in independent request, bus request line is separately provided to all the system, right? So bus arbiter controller will be having idea about which system is asking for bus control. And as if system bus is free, then bus arbiter controller can provide a grant to that particular system. But here, my dear students, there are few disadvantages. If you observe how many lines that we need to have in independent request, as if you have 1000 computer connected in network, then you will have to have 1000 lines for bus grant and 1000 line for bus request, right? So you need to have 2000 lines, right? In polling method, bus request line, that is common, but bus grant, that is there based on address. So for example, if you have 1024 number of computers, then for that you need to have 10 bit addressing. So 10 lines are required for bus grant address and one line requires for bus request. So with 11 lines, you can have pooling method. With daisy chain method, even though you have 1000 computer, you just need to have two lines only, right? So in terms of wiring, complexity will be very high with independent request. It will be less with pooling, and it is very less with daisy chain. But in terms of secured connection, you can say independent request is best. In terms of delay, independent request is best, right? Here, let us try to compare all three techniques based on various parameters. So if you talk about design, then daisy chain design is simplest, pooling is bit complex, and independent request, that is very complex. Why? The reason is number of wires, that is way high in independent request. In terms of reliability, you can say daisy chain is not reliable. Why? The reason is if any system fails, then further system cannot have bus grant, right? Pooling is fully reliable. Why? The reason is if any system fails, then also other system is not getting disturbed, right? In independent request, if any system fails, still other system is not getting affected. That's why pooling and independent request systems are fully reliable, but daisy chain is not reliable. In terms of performance, you can say daisy chain performance is weak. Pooling method is having better performance compared to daisy chain, but independent request is having excellent performance, right? When we talk about upgradation, then daisy chain upgradation is very easy, but in pooling, reconfiguration is required. For example, right now you are having 1024 number of computers, but as soon as you interface more than 1024 computers, you need to increase address lines, right? For example, 1024 computers are there, then you need to have how many address lines? 10 address lines. But once you add single computer with 1024, then you need to increase address lines. Now you need to have 11 address lines, right? So in pooling, reconfiguration is required as if you do upgradation. And in independent request, complexity will increase as you upgrade the system. Why? The reason is with every system, there will be bus grant and bus request lines. So as you increase more computers, complexity will increase. Too much wiring will be there. When you talk about cost, then least cost will be there with daisy chain. Bit less cost will be there with pooling, and cost will be way high with independent request. Why? The reason is number of lines. And here, what I have done is I have placed one example. Why? The reason is I have seen at least one question is coming based on this topic. So I should give you a bit hint regarding what kind of questions may be there. So lines are there as per 8 systems. So how many bus grant line will be there, bus request line will be there, and bus busy line will be there. See, bus busy line, that is common for all methods, right? So that will be one only. But when we talk about bus request line, so bus request line is one for daisy chain and one for pooling, but bus request line is separately provided for all system in independent request. So bus grant and bus request, that is 8, but with pooling system, bus grant will be 3. Why? The reason is for 8, as per 2 to the power 3, 8 will be there, bus grant line, that will be 3, that gives you address of system. So that is how various parameters are there. I hope you have understood all those things. Still, if anything that you like to share it with me, please note it down in comments. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.